As of December 26, 2021, there are 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting. These include volcanoes such as Piton de la Fournaise in the French Overseas Territory of Reunion, which just produced a new effusive eruption accompanied with towering lava flows on December 22nd. It also includes the Great Sikkim volcano in Alaska, which has been continuously erupting since May 25th of 2021, and has just created a new large lobe of andesite lava. With this being said, here are a few of this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Russia's Kamchatka, a massive stratovolcano which produced a 15-kilometer-long pyroclastic flow at one point in the last 10,000 years has an ongoing intrusion of magma underneath its edifice. Meanwhile, in Tonga, the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano, which is famous for its spectacular island-forming eruption from 2014 to 2015, just produced a new explosive eruption. And now for this week's top story. In Iceland, the famous Geldingadalur volcano, which erupted for 6 months earlier this year, has a chance of erupting once again as magma is again on the move. The Geldingadalur volcano spectacularly erupted in Iceland from March 19th to September 18th of 2021. During this time span, a new shield volcano was constructed out of several northeast trending fissure vents, covering 4.3 square miles of scenic tundra with a layer of molten rock. This eruption was originally preceded by an intense series of several thousand earthquakes as fresh magma was injected into the crust from Iceland's underlying hotspot. Over the span of several weeks, these earthquakes became shallower and shallower until finally an eruption occurred. Well, a similar series of events unexpectedly occurred beginning on December 21st at 5 p.m. local time. In the several days since, more than 6,000 earthquakes have almost continuously rocked the peninsula, the largest of which was a magnitude 4.9. These earthquakes had a definite magmatic signature to them, as a sill of magma was moving underneath the Geldingadalur volcano. Volumes of molten rock from this sill could randomly travel upwards, which might then reach the surface and generate a new eruption. So far, these earthquakes have been centered in three areas, each of which could become the site of a new volcanic eruption with rather little notice. The most likely spot for a new eruption is the southernmost of the group, as approximately half of the recent earthquakes have occurred there. Of course, an eruption is still not a certainty. This is despite the fact that there is a near-identical signal now in terms of ground displacement which occurred right before March 19th. Only time will tell whether this fresh intrusion of magma will indeed reach the surface and produce another effusive eruption. Meanwhile, in the western Kamchatka peninsula of Russia, there are signs of activity at a volcano which has not erupted since 1740. Myself and other patrons decided to scan Kamchatka on satellite to check for any signals of uplift at known volcanoes. Well, we found such a signal at the Ichinsky volcano. This may not look like much, but in all likelihood, a two-pronged body of magma is intruding underneath the volcano, possibly from a west-to-east fissure, causing small amounts of uplift. However, I deem this signal to not be sufficient to warrant an increase in alert level. My interpretation is that the volume of magma involved is small and deep, similar to the 1995-2001 uplift at the Three Sisters volcano in Oregon, where 13 centimeters of uplift occurred at 7 kilometers depth and did not end in a new eruption. Of course, I could not find any records of seismographs being actively kept on Ichinsky, so we could technically be surprised by a new eruption, although I deem this to be unlikely. If a new eruption was to occur, I would expect a short-duration eruption to construct a new lava dome out of rhyodacite rock on its summit. In Tonga, the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano produced a new explosive eruption on the morning of December 20th. This eruption occurred at the same vent which connected the two islands during an eruption from 2014 to 2015, which is shown here. Video taken of this eruption showed characteristic phreatomagmatic explosions as quantities of ash, lava, and pumice were ejected onto the surface after interacting with seawater within the volcanic crater. Due to this seawater, the eruption has a distinguishably white plume, albeit with small quantities of ash. In all likelihood, this explosive eruption will continue for another 1 to 2 weeks, with the only confirmed negative effect being so far is the cancellation of several commercial aircraft flights. On a final note, here's a quick list of every volcano which is currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes at raised alert statuses which are not erupting but could erupt in the near future. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.